I honestly didn't even know he was injured. I did see him retreated a little bit. And there was times where I took charge. I didn't know anything about his hands. That wasn't really what I noticed or even focused on. I just said, I need to dig in.
But, Jesse was, I'm talking about Jesse Vargas, critical about the decision to have you as Miguel Cotto's opponent. Is there still bad blood there? Can you see that rematch ever? Do you want that rematch in the past?
Who knows? Honestly, I'm not really thinking about him. If HBO ever asked for it, that would be different. But if Jesse Vargas fought me tonight, trust me, everything would be completely different.
That's right.
Big mistake in that camp with him. And I learned from it. I really learned from it. But I'm not gonna take that away from him. He was the better man that night. But I know that he's not messing with me. So, you know, things happen in life, and I move forward.
Well, who went and tell that
face about?
You know, it depends on where he is now, where I am. And right now, I'm grateful.
They only fight once every 2 years.
I want to ask Andre a question. Can you just give your perspective as the trainer of what you've seen and the changes he was able to make over the last couple of years, maybe since the Vargas fight, where he could come into the ring here and get this kind of victory?
Well, as you can see, he made an entire 360 turnabout. This was a tough task. David, Saddam's father, and I, we wrestled with it. And from the beginning, when he said we were going to be boxing Cotto, I said, no, we're not. He said, yes, we are. I said, no, we're not. Yes, we are. And then we finally were fighting him, and we had to turn it up on Saddam. Saddam is as good as any elite fighter on the planet. The only limitation Saddam will ever have is what he puts upon himself. He can beat every welterweight and junior middleweight out there. As you saw tonight, there were a lot of media folks who were saying Saddam was going to lose. This was a horrible fight. I'm not going to watch it. And this is my baby. When they say things like that, I get upset because we've been through the thick and thin from the very beginning. So when you talk about him, you're talking about me. And if you talk about me, he's kind-hearted and he's sweet. I'll burn you up. So we worked hard. He rose to the occasion. And like I said, it wasn't easy. We had to push, shove, and get to that point where we could be where we're at right now. Saddam is the junior middleweight champion of the world.
And do you think that he's best suited to stay and defend the title, or like you talked about, maybe being better off at welterweight?
Well, listen, we don't know what we'll do next. That's up to Oscar and Golden Boy and David and myself and Lenny. We sit down, we commiserate, and we find out what might be the best direction for Saddam to move in. But I can guarantee you this. I don't think I'll have to yell at Saddam to go running again ever.
Dre, congratulations to both of you, by the way. Were you surprised when Saddam hurt Cotto so early in the fight? And what did you say to him when he came to the corner after that round?
Well, I wasn't surprised because we had been working on some things, but it caught me off guard. But I think it surprised Saddam a little bit more than it did us. And I wanted him at that point just to be sharp enough to take advantage of when you get a man hurt. You have to remember in boxing, the actuality of hurting someone and noticing it is almost like a millisecond at times. And if you don't notice it, you can let someone get off the hook. So he didn't, I don't know if he actually saw it, but I know when we saw it, we were saying, Saddam, get up on it. You know, just start working a little bit more. But in his mind, he did the right thing. He kept control. I would have liked to seen him have picked it up, but he still did a great job. And, you know, we'll work on that. He's a nice guy. That's what happened.
First of all, how did it feel walking into Madison Square Garden, a world title fight? It's everybody there with the exception of maybe 10% of the crowd. It was a pro-Cotto crowd tonight. You felt it like the ring. You felt it. when you were being interviewed by Max Kellerman. What were your emotions walking to the ring and then when the scorecards were being read?
First, it felt pretty good, honestly. I did see my fans there as well. Might not have been as much, you know, and Cotto's fans overpowered, of course, and I was already expecting and knew that. Believe it or not, when they would cheer, it felt like it was for me at times. I took it in. I just took that whole thing in, and then the decision, when it came my way, which I was praying and hoping for, it's just a blessing. I'm grateful, and I'm just happy. I'm ready for what's next.